Mrs. Sabourin.
Good afternoon, and welcome to Sacred Hearts Parish. We welcome those present here at church and also those attending Mass via live stream at home. My name is Janet Champagne, Aaron Giard, and I will be your lectors today. We gather today as a community of believers to celebrate God's great gifts to us, God's Word and the Eucharist. Today we celebrate the 26th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our presider is Father John. Our Mass intention is for Gabriel and Gloria Augusta. Our second collection today is for the pilot. In today's gospel reading, Jesus rebukes John, who stopped people from ministering in Jesus' name because they do not follow us. How often are we guilty of the same thing? Do we allow human alliances or cliques to get in our way of our common identity as Christians? Let us hear today's readings with an eye to how we as a parish might help and invite and form new leaders. Let us pray that we do not fall into the trap of failing to make space for people who are not yet one of us. Let us now stand and give praise and glory to our God.
Please join in our opening song, number 301, The God of All Grace, number 301.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. We gather here this day as a parish community to praise God. Let's now pause briefly, call to mind our sins, and welcome God's mercy and peace this hour. I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my fault, most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power, above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord came down in the cloud and spoke to Moses. Taking some of the spirit that was on Moses, the Lord bestowed it on the 70 elders, and as the spirit came to rest on them, they prophesied. Now, two men, one named Eldad and the other Medad, were not in the gathering, but had been left in the camp. They too had been on the list, but had not gone out to the tent. Yet the Spirit came to rest on them also, and they prophesied in the camp. So when a young man quickly told Moses, "Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp," Joshua, son of Nun, who was from his youth, had been Moses' aide, said, "Moses, my lord, stop them." But Moses answered him, "Are you jealous for my sake? Would that all the people of the Lord were prophets. Would that the Lord might bestow his spirit on them all." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Precepts of the Lord give joy to the earth. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. Though your servant is careful of them, very diligent in keeping them, yet who can detect failings? Cleanse me from my unknown fault. Precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart. From wanton sin especially restrain your servant. Let it not rule
From the letter of St. James. Come now, you rich, weep and wail over your impending miseries. Your wealth has rotted away, your clothes have become moth-eaten, your gold and silver have corroded, and that corrosion will be a testimony against you. It will devour your flesh like a fire. You have stored up treasure for the last days. Behold, the wages you withheld from the workers who have harvested your fields are crying aloud, and the cries of the harvesters have reached the ears of the Lord of hosts. You have lived on earth in luxury and pleasure. You have fattened your hearts for the day of slaughter. You have condemned, you have murdered the righteous one. He offers you no resistance. The word of the Lord.
Friends, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. At that time, John said to Jesus, "Teacher, we saw someone driving out demons in your name. We try to prevent him because he does not follow us." Jesus replied, "Do not prevent him. There is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. For whoever is not against us is for us. Anyone who gives you a cup of water to drink because you belong to Christ, amen I say to you, will surely not lose his reward. Whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him if a great millstone were put around his neck, be thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life maimed than with two hands to go into Gehenna, into the unquenchable fire. And if your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life crippled than with two feet to be thrown into Gehenna. And if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. Better for you to enter into the kingdom of God with one eye than with two eyes to be thrown into Gehenna, where the worm does not die and the fire is not quenched." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good afternoon, everyone. One of the areas of my life that I work with people is in marriage preparation. And I was with a couple this morning getting ready for a wedding here next Saturday at 2 o'clock. and to sense their joy and their happiness. And I try to spend a few meetings with them over the course of their preparation time to help them prepare for their marriage journey. I always say to them, we have a wedding day, but a marriage is many years. And so we have to spend time together to discuss a bit about their marriage. So they go to pre-Cana program we offer in the Archdiocese. But also I say, chat with people who are married, get their insights. And me as a priest can give you a little insight too in terms of your marriage. And one of the areas I talk about with the couples is about decision making. And how decision making must be a collaborative effort. One person in the marriage cannot control all that. One person can have that power idea. It's always my way. There must be a collaborative element in terms of decision making. That involves good communication, good listening skills, and having that mentality of a win-win situation and not a win-loss situation. If everybody is happy, I want to say everybody, the husband and wife are happy as to the outcome of a decision. Whether it's what house to buy, where to live, or what kind of milk to buy at the store. All different levels of decision making, some more serious than others, of course. So today in the gospel, in the first reading, talking about control. And of course, I always discuss with the couple about inviting God into the decision making and not be so controlling and give no space for God in your marriage and your decision making. But for all of us, whether we're married, divorced, single, wherever life is in our life, widowed, that we all have decisions to make as to where we go in life. And sometimes you and I control things too much. We have our own mind made up. We disallow God's presence in the moment. And I think today's readings from Numbers and the Gospel gives great example about that. Here is Joshua, very critical of God, not allowing Eldad and Medad to have the power of the Spirit because they weren't there at the meeting time. But God, through Moses, gave them the power of prophecy and of Spirit-filled life because they were men of faith. Fast forward many centuries to the Gospel time of Mark, and here we have people criticizing because they're doing good work. They're not one of the Christian insiders. So again, the question is about outsiders and insiders. Who can do God's work and who is controlling the situation? Who has the power? We've heard that phrase, I think, in AA work, let go, let God. And sometimes we have to do just that. I can't control all of this in my life. I have to be open to God's Spirit and see God working in my life, seeing good things happening. And we as Christians don't have the corner of all goodness in the world. These days, very popular on a weekend to see a lot of these walkathons, right? Breast cancer awareness, or Alzheimer's research, or kidney research, and so forth, food banks, and all is good. There is great work being done there. So no matter whether they're Christian, non-Christian, believers, no believers, all is good, and we can't have any really commentary or judgment about the goodness there. That's why in today's gospel, the Lord says, the person who gives a cup of water is blessed because of that kind deed versus controlling that, well, is that person a Christian or not? The Lord said, that goodness means that they're one of us in good heart. In those days, giving a cup of water meant so much in that arid, barren land. It was a sign of hospitality, a sign of welcome, a sign of connection, of being one with a person in life. And so I think this key theme that runs through the readings today is about love and goodness and avoiding that control that somehow seeps into our life easily, in our families, in our relationships far and wide, of, you know, what am I trying to do? Why can't I give more space and opportunity for God to work in our lives and to do great things? And the gospel reminds us too about how we must always give good example to others in life. And the Lord used that hyperbole tool to say, you know, cutting off your hand or your eye. That's hyperbole, of course, that we must really do our best to live our life with God every day to the best of our ability and give a good witness to others. But that takes an awareness, that takes conviction, that takes insight to really believe that God works in our lives, works in our hearts, and that you and I can respond in kind to live that faith-filled message with God always in our being. And of course, as James says in today's readings, when we do that, we avoid the pitfalls of storing up riches in this world and failing to work on our interior life so that we can store up riches with God in our hearts. So my friends, today, let's go forth and do our best to honestly ask ourselves, how do I approach relationships with others in marriage or friendships, family life? Am I sometimes controlling? Am I sometimes, you know, really looking at that power element of life and avoiding the question of where is God? How is God guiding me in this decision to love and give my best to others? And just take a step back and really be aware of God's goodness there, challenging me to be my best. And then to heed this gospel and Old Testament story about allowing God to deepen our faith, to avoid that controlling element of life, and to let God inform our heart, our mind, our spirit, to let God work in our lives. Sometimes in group activities, we stifle God's work by saying, oh, that will never work. We tried that 20 years ago, and that's not the solution. Or in our family life, when there's issues and concerns, God, give me wisdom to allow this situation to resolve itself. Healing, new life, peace. Versus controlling it ourselves, saying, it'll never work. It's over. It can't happen that way. But I think as we take a step back, listen to God in our hearts and our spirits, and trust that God will do great things for us, then we see things develop and grow and have new life and ultimately peace in our world. Some thoughts today, my friends, to think about this week, avoiding controlling, avoiding being too attached to this world and trusting that God will do great things if we allow God to do so. But that means relinquishing that control, that possessiveness of our lives and all the stuff we have, and allowing God to guide us and give us strength and peace. May God bless my friends this day along those lines to go forth and journey together and try to always foster win-win situations in life, collaborative, decision-making, openness to God, and there we sense the fullness of God in our life always. Let us now stand as you and I profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting always in God's unfailing love and mercy, let's now turn to our God with our prayers and petitions.
For leaders in this world, that the Lord will touch their hearts with mercy and their minds with wisdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all people may grow in their awareness of God's love for them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the young adults who will be confirmed here at Sacred Hearts tomorrow, it says this afternoon, but I think it's tomorrow, that the Holy Spirit may dwell in them abundantly, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick and those who have recently died, that God may console them and their families, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In gratitude for the priests of this parish, that on this priesthood Sunday, God may bless all priests, especially Father John, Father Dan, and Father Richard, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Gabriel and Gloria Augusta, who are especially remembered at this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the prayers and concerns we silently call to mind. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty God, this day, listen to our prayers. Grant that our prayers may grow increasingly in line with your divine will and love with your divine heart. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As the gifts are being prepared, please join in singing number 727, Stand By Me, number 727.
When the storms of life are raging, Lord, stand by me. When the
stand by me, stand
Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours, O God, the Almighty Father, grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessing be laid open before all of us today, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My friends, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you have loved in your Son. By his obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks. As an exaltation, we pray together. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, during his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which is poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together, Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, the clergy, religious, and all your faith-filled people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. We pray this day for Gabriel and Gloria Augusta. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, we have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress of life, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who will live and reign forever and ever. Amen. My friends, the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's now turn to our friends and offer a sign of peace. My friends, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Christ.
Our communion song is number 471, Fly Like a Bird, number 471.
We have just a couple announcements this evening. Religious education has started. We are looking for a fourth grade catechist and a hall monitor for Sundays, and a third and eighth grade catechist for Wednesdays. Please contact May Ba, Director of Faith Formation, for more information. And we wish to thank everyone who helped make last weekend's picnic a success. Look for photos from the event in today's and next weekend's bulletin. Thank you and have a pleasant weekend.
Thanks, Janet, for that parish news. And also, please pray tomorrow for our confirmation students. We have 55 being confirmed tomorrow afternoon by Bishop Hennessy here in the church, so please pray for them. They worked very hard this past year on Zoom. It was very difficult to it was very challenging to use Zoom as the mode of catechesis, but they stuck with it all year long. And we're here Thursday night for a reflection night, and they're wonderful. They're juniors in high school this fall, and they're great kids, great families. So please pray tomorrow for those youngsters. Have a great night before the rain comes. Enjoy tomorrow. We'll see you soon. Let's now stand for our final prayers. Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death in our lives, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. My friends, the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God. Enjoy your week. See you all soon.
Please join in singing our closing song, number 422, How Great Thou Art, number 422.